Hey guys, I am CMA Supra, and this is a Black Ops 2 Zombies Transit Building Guide. So, it's a video about how to build everything in the transit map. So click any of those icons on the screen, if you turn on annotations that is, and you'll be able to skip ahead in the video and see how to build each individual item, or you can always just watch the whole video that I made for you and see how to build every single item in this game. So, go ahead and click. Clickety click click. Because I'm going to start the video in 3... 2, 1. Video starting now. Alright guys, before I go on explaining how to build even the first item, I want to say one thing, and that is, the order you build things in does not matter at all, and the order you pick up parts in does not matter at all, just you can only carry one part at a time when you're building something. So the first thing we're going to build is right here, on this workbench. It's in the bus stop where you spawn. And this is going to be the turbine, which is used for powering anything that needs power, such as perks or certain doors, at least until you have the power turned on. And the three parts you need are the mannequin, the fan, and the wing or blade or whatever you want to call it. And the first part, the mannequin, is right here on this panel. Let's go attach it to the workbench. And then the second part is the fan, and that is located right behind the workbench on these seats. And I don't want the zombie to kill me. Get over here, zombie. Yeah, that's good enough. Okay, now let's attach the fan to the turbine. And the third part is the wing or blade, or once again, whatever you want to call it. And that is located right here under the payphones on this side of the bus stop. And let's go attach it, and then we will be done with the turbine. The next thing we're going to do is build the zombie shield, which is at the diner area 2. And yeah, let's go over there now. So the second thing that you can build is the zombie shield, and that's at the diner area. You can actually build it in the garage here. If you open this door, and then it's built right here at this workbench, and the zombie shield protects your back from zombies when you are not equipping it, and it protects your front from zombies when you do equip it. So the first part you'll need, or rather the two parts you will need, are the car door and the dolly. The car door is found in one of three places. One is on the side of the car right here. The other is right here, which in this case is where it is. And the third place is right here under, well, next to the sink in the bathroom. So let me go grab the car door, and we will attach that. That zombie's gonna get me. Come here, zombie. I don't want you to kill me. That would be very, very bad. I'm making a tutorial here. Okay, so let's attach the car door. And then let's go get the dolly. And the dolly is located in one of two places, both of which are in the diner itself. So let's open this. And one place it can be located is right here, in which case it is here. And the other place it can be located is right here behind the booth. So now that we have the dolly, let's go attach the dolly. And then the zombie shield will be done, because there are only two parts to build this one, and I think it's actually the only two-part item in this game. I'm not thinking about it right now, but I'm pretty sure it is. So yeah, there we go, a zombie shield. The next item we're going to build is the turret, which is located in Area 3, the farm. So let's go there next. Alright, so the third item that you can build is in Area number 3, the farm here. And it is the turret, which will shoot zombies if you give it a power source, such as the turbine I am carrying. So you'll need three parts for this. One is the lawnmower, the second one is the bag of ammo, and the third one is an RPD. So let's first go for the lawnmower. Let's do this in the order I listed them. The lawnmower can be found near the back door of the house, so either right here, next to this barrel, or right over here. And in this case, it's right over here. So the place that you build this is in the house right here. On the first floor, basically the front room, if you go in the front door instead of the back door like I did. I'm getting surrounded by zombies. Anyways, the second item that we wanted to get for this, what was it on my list? The bag of ammo. So the bag of ammo has two places it can spawn. The first is right here in this cherry-colored bookshelf. Or whatever this would be. And the second place it can spawn is in this cherry-colored bookshelf. And let's go ahead and attach the bag of ammo, because we found it already. And the third item is the RPD. Now, the RPD has two or three possible locations. Two of them are in the shed, if there are two. Otherwise, there's just one possible location in the... not the shed. The farm. This place. The farm. And in this case, it is right here. So let's go ahead and grab it. It's on these barrels. Sometimes it's on another set of barrels up here, I believe. Yeah, sometimes it's on these barrels. So there are three possible locations, two of which are upstairs in the farm, or the barn, whatever you want to call this place. And the third location that it can possibly spawn is in the house upstairs. And I'm going to go ahead and show you that before I attach this part. So the third place it can spawn is somewhere on this porch out here, or right here on the wall. So, now that we have the RPD, let's go ahead and attach it. And then we will have completed the turret. So, there we go. Take the turret. I'm not going to actually do that because I want to keep my... I want to keep my turbine. So, there we go. There we go. The turret is completed. The next part is going to be in... let me look at my notes. The power switch, which is going to be in the power area, which is area number 4. This is area number 3, so let's go to area number 4, the power area, next. And we will build the power switch. Okay, so the fourth thing that you can build is the power switch, and you really need to build this so that you can get the power turned on and always have access to all your perks. And the place you do it is in area number 4, the power area. And you just open this door for 750, go downstairs, and then all the parts will be down here. So now there are three parts you need for this. One is the box, which is actually located right there. And then you also need the switch and the zombie arm. I've already found the switch, it's right there as well. But I'm going to go ahead and list all the locations for each item that they can possibly spawn. And I need the zombie to quit chasing me, so hold on, let me look at my notes here. Because I wrote all this down, I have it in my head, like I can find things that I'm playing, but I need to write it down when I'm making a tutorial. So, one place for the power box is on the left of the entrance hallway, which would be right here. You drop down here, this is where you enter. That's a place for the power box, that's a possible spot for the power box. The second possible spot is leaning on the barrels in the inner circle, so this is the inner circle right here, and it is actually right there. This time. The third possible spot is in the power switch room, somewhere in here, and it'll be very obvious where it is. I think there's like two spots they can spawn in there. But anyways, let's go ahead and grab the power box and attach it, and then we will move on to the switch, which is the next part. And the workbench is right over here at the back of the power area. I really do hope that zombie does not get me. Wow, that was close. Okay, so the switch. There are how many possible spots? Two, pretty much. Let me read. By the barrels, just after leaving the entrance hallway, and in the power room itself. Or the power switch room. So one possible spot for the switch is right here, where I'm looking. And the other possible spot is in the power switch room itself, which is this room where you're building the power switch. And in this case, it is in the power switch room. The bus is leaving, I don't really care. So I grabbed it over there, as you saw, and I need this zombie to quit chasing me. And I would make him a crawler, for those of you who are thinking I should just make him a crawler, I would, except crawlers don't survive anymore. So that's not an option. And if you don't believe me, try making a crawler survive, it won't work. They will die as soon as you leave the area because they can't run. So... there we go. Next we need the zombie arm. The zombie arm has three possible spots, and I actually have all three of these memorized. One possible spot is right here at the entrance stairs for the inner circle. It'll be on the ground here. The second possible spot is at the other side, at the top of these stairs. And the third possible spot, where it is in this case, is next to these pipes. And it is kind of hard to see with the light, but you'll have to find it, and it's not too bad to see. So let's go ahead and add the zombie arm, and then the power switch will be finished, and then I can flip the power on. There we go, power is turning on. Wow, that was like singing. So the next thing we're going to build is the electric trap, which is actually just behind this door. I'm going to wait for the power to turn on, and then we will do that. Alright, so the fifth thing we are going to build is after you turn on the power, this area will open and you can build the electric trap right here on this workbench. So this requires three parts, one of which is the table, which I have actually found here. And let me look at my notes to see how I intended to describe this, because it's actually a little complicated to describe. So all three items rotate their spawns randomly somewhere in this whole power room. So all three items will be in this power room, but they're going to be randomly located, and sometimes parts will switch spots. So the three main areas to look are on top of barrels near the tombstone perk and in the window near the tombstone perk. Why are my keys not working? There we go. Oh, it would suck if I went down. So in this case, I have found a battery. I should actually list the three parts needed. So you need... What do you need? You need a lamp. You need an electric rod, and you need a battery. So in this case, I found the battery here, but let's actually go find the lamp first, because that is first on my list. I've also found the electric rod, but I still want to find the fence first. And I guess I should explain the three possible spots. So I did mention the barrels on top of the, or near the tombstone perk, and in the window near the tombstone perk, but also under the initial platform, which is this platform. If you go under it using this, you can find stuff down here as well. Oh, jeez, don't go down. Aww. Okay, then. Let's just wait. There we go. There doesn't actually seem to be anything down here, so the lamp I'm actually having a little trouble finding. Where is the lamp? It is somewhere down here. All three parts have to be down here. The only thing is you have to find them. Or rather up here, because we are actually up in a building, aren't we? So let me look for the lamp really quickly, because I can't seem to find it at a glance. Oh, there it is. Here we go. So it's in this window. That's a possible spot. We will attach the lamp after I can get this zombie to go elsewhere. Come over here, zombie. Right over here. And then let's go attach the lamp. And that will be the first part of the three parts needed for this. And let's run over here. So the second part I listed was what? I just want to do this in order, not that it really matters. The electric rod, and then the battery. Okay, so electric rod I actually found right over there. I'm looking at it with my gun. Another spot it can be is under the platform, right on top of that box, right here. That's another spot it can be, and another spot is right over there. So those are the spots that the electric rod can be. But I found it over here, so let's go grab it. And what's this zombie going to do in terms of getting me? Let's hope he doesn't hit me. I hear him. Oh. Yeah, I think that was pretty close. So the third part is the battery. And in my case, this is located right here. I think I have also found it here. This is another possible spot for the lamp right here. Like I said, all three things will be somewhere in this area, and they're not too hard to find. So let's go attach the battery, and then the electric trap will be finished. And the next part we will... Actually, I need to get this zombie away. I wouldn't have had enough time to build the part. But once we finish this electric trap, the next thing we will build is the super weapon. Woohoo! It's that thing that kills zombies really, really quickly. So, electric trap. There we go. I don't know if I ever explained what the electric trap is for. It is for basically killing zombies instantly, like the traps in previous zombie maps. And it requires a power source, such as my turbine, which I am not going to give up yet. Hey, the bus is back. How convenient. So, there we go. Electric trap is finished. Next one will be the super weapon. So let's go work on building that next. Call down the thunder. Alright, so the next thing we're going to build is the super weapon. Woohoo! It's a fancy gun. So the workbench is located in the town, and the bar building, to be specific, and the workbench is right over there. So the parts we need for this are... Let me look at my notes while I chase... or run from a zombie, rather. Not chase a zombie, that'd be backwards. We need a jet engine, a handle, a light, and some wires. So let's go for the jet engine first, and that... Well, I do want to take the bus, so... Let's go to the jet engine first, and I will explain all of its possible locations. Alright, so the jet engine has two possible spots. Both of them are in the tunnel between areas 1 and 2, which are the bus stop and the diner. I am currently in this tunnel, and one possible spot is right here. The other possible spot is over here, right there, and that's where it is in this case. So I'm going to go ahead and pick it up, and we'll move on to the next part, which is... What's next in my notes? I know the part, but what's next in my notes? The handle! We're going to go to the handle next, after I attach this part. I'm going to attach it off camera, and we will just move on to the handle, because you already know where the workbench is, and you know how to attach parts to a workbench. Alright, so we're going to find the handle now. And that is located in Nacht der Untoten, which is a World at War map. They actually put the whole map in this map, and I'm going to be showing you the whole way to get there, in case any of you don't know how to find Nacht der Untoten. So right now we're at the power area, and Nacht der Untoten is in the cornfields between areas 3 and 4, so between the farm and the power area. So we're actually going to be running backwards here. So let's go ahead and run backwards into the cornfields and find Nacht der Untoten. Now, I guess I gotta find cornfields first. Get this off of my head. You ain't nothing. It is kind of hard to find, but it's not too bad. It's in a pretty narrow spot, so it's hard to miss unless you are having a lot of trouble seeing because of the fog. Okay, there we go. There's some cornfields. You can actually see a power tower right there, sort of, kinda. And we are trying to find the entrance for Nacht der Untoten, which is going to be in the opposite side of the power tower. So the power tower is on the right, because we're running backwards. So Nacht der Untoten's going to be on the left. So let's look for an opening on the left. And the cars right here are the best opening that you can take, these cars. So let's go in the cornfields. And when we come to an intersection, we turn right. It's actually not an intersection, that was just a corner. And then we turn left into this narrow passage, which is kind of hard to find. It's easy to miss. And we are at Nacht der Untoten. Now, they didn't put the whole map in it, like I said, but you can tell they put a huge amount of it. Sadly, you can't get out of this room, but oh well. So, we are looking for a handle. And there are some possible spawn locations for it. Here is one, apparently. I've never actually had it right there. I've always had it over on top of this, which is why I came here first as soon as I got here. So that's one possible spot for the handle. And I guess another possible spot is right in here. But it will always spawn in Nacht der Untoten. So you could just have, you might just have to look around all over this room and find it. But it's usually right there. I guess this time it was over here. So let's go ahead and grab it, and I will attach it to the super weapon off camera, and then we will find the next part, which is going to be the light. I actually just realized something. I should tell you guys how to get out of here, because it's kind of confusing. It's as confusing as it is to get in here. So you want to go out the pretty much this, well, yeah, this exit is the best one to take, and then you turn right, and then here's the corner again. We just follow it around to the left, and we will be at the car crash right here. So if I go this way, it will be the power area. If I go this way, it will be the farm. So I'm going to go ahead and run to the power area, and then area 5, the town, and attach this weapon, not this weapon, this part, to the super weapon, and then we will find the light. But I'm going to attach this off-camera, as I said. Okay, so the next part is the light, and that is always going to be located in a cabin where you find the Bowie knife. This knife, actually, I've already got the Bowie knife, but I left the part there just so I can show you guys this. The cabin is located between areas 4 and 5, so that would be between power and this area, the town. So once again, we're going to be running backwards. And the only reason I'm running back... Oh gosh, I don't want the bus to kill the zombie. Get over here, zombie. Yeah, okay, good. I forgot the bus was not going to drive right through. So, areas 4 and 5, and we're going to be running backwards again just because the super weapon's right here, and it's much faster to go from area 5 to area 4 than it is to go from area 5 all the way forward to area 4, if that made any sense. So let's go ahead and run backwards. I'm once again going to be showing this on camera because it's kind of hard to find. And personally, in my opinion, it's actually harder to find this cabin than it is to find Nocturne and Toten. Simply because the cabin, while it is next to the road here, and we're actually going to be looking on the left, it doesn't make it obvious. But here is a wide open area. This is what you want to find. And the cabin is somewhere around here in this wide open area. Here we go. Here's the cabin. It's much easier to find if you're running from the other direction. As you can see, the road is actually right down here. So if you're running from the power area, you'll look for a wide open area like this, and you'll actually see the glow of the Bowie knife. So I've already bought the Bowie knife, otherwise I would buy it again. And now there are three possible spots for the light to spawn, but they're all in the cabin. So area one is in this fireplace. Area 2 is on this bench on the opposite side of the fireplace. And area 3 is right here, which in this case is where it is, except I have to grab it from this side. There we go. So there we have the light, and I'm going to go attach this off camera. And the fourth thing that we will find after I attach the light is the wires. So let's go do that. Actually, something I just realized, that's more of a pressure gauge, not a light. So we're actually going to change the name to a pressure gauge, and I probably changed it in editing to a pressure gauge instead of light. Just thought I'd mention that. I just realized that's actually a pressure gauge, not a light. It just kind of looks like a light. So now let's go find, what was it, the wires? Yeah, the wires. That's all that's left. The fourth item. Okay. Okay, so now we're going to find the lights for the super weapon. They're located... not the lights, the wires. Wow. The wires are located in the electrical house. As you can see, that's where I am. And there are two or three possible spots for them to spawn, depending on how you think of it. So the first one is going to be down here. Let's actually go over here. Right on that platform, right there where I'm looking, that's one possible spot. Another possible spot is in here somewhere. And the third possible spot... I want to make sure the zombie's not going to trap me if I go there, because it is... Oh, you're right there! Yeah, you're going to trap me. It is actually kind of a dangerous spot to get it, if you're coming at it from below like I was about to. So let's go all the way over here. Jump over here. That way I can safely get it and show you guys where it is. Let's go back on this platform. And I think we're fine now. So the third possible spot is right here, which is where it is in this case. So that's what they look like, and I'm going to grab them. And zombie actually can't jump down that, which is why I like that spot. But he can jump down this. Yeah, let's move. Okay, so we have the wires. I showed you the three possible spots, and I'm going to actually go attach these on camera, because that is the last part of the super weapon. Then we will have built the super weapon. So yeah, let's go attach these. So here we are in the bar in town, and let's attach the wires and finish the super weapon. There we go. Oh yeah. Press F to take the jet gun. It is done. I'm not actually going to pick it up, because next we have another tutorial, and that's going to be the... what is it? The navigation table, which is useful for the Easter egg. So let's go build that, and then we will still have more after that to build. We're not done, even if you think we're done, because I actually thought we were done when I was writing my notes after this. After the navigation table, rather. But then I remembered there's more. So let's go build the navigation table now. Okay, so the next thing we're going to build is the navigation table. So I'm going to start here at the farm, and I'm actually going to show you guys how to find the workbench. It's about as hard to find as Nocturne Toten because it's actually straight across from Nocturne Toten in the cornfields. So we're going to start at the farm this time, not at the power area, simply because this is the direction I was going, and I happened to be at the farm first. So the power tower that we're looking for, which is where you build the navigation table, is under, or not under, what am I saying? It's on the left side as we're running. While Nocturne Toten would be on the right side. So we're going to look for a hole in the left side of the cornfield, and it'll actually be straight across, the entrance will be straight across from the entrance to Nocturne Toten. So this shouldn't be too hard to find, we just have to find the same car wreck, or we can just look for a gap and call it good. Such as this gap right here, but I'm actually not going to take that because I don't like that gap. That gap has fire in it, and it hurts. So here's the car wreck to Nocturne Toten, and on the left side is a gap to the power tower, electrical tower, I don't know, whatever you want to call it. Let's actually go left over here, and then go right, and we will be at the tower pretty soon here. Okay, here we are. What? I didn't build it in this game. Do you only have to build it once? Gee, that's interesting. I only have to build it once? Because I did not build it in this game. I built it, well, earlier today in a different game. Okay, well, I will just show you guys, well, where the parts are, I guess. So anyways, here is the place that you build it, and you can actually insert the nav card, which last time it told me I had the wrong nav card. I'm not really sure what was up with that, but oh well, let's go look at where the parts are. I'm actually surprised it's here. I mean, I didn't build it this game. Oh well. Okay guys, so the first part we need for the navigation table is the meteor, and that is found in this right here in you. Oh gosh, I gotta kill him. I start a new round, but anyways, the meteor is going to be right there. You might have to crouch to pick it up. And that's, then you just go attach the meteor to the navigation table. And the next part is going to be the nav card, which is actually right back here, but I already have it in my inventory. But you can find it right back here, pick it up here or somewhere. It's just on the back of the bus stop is all. I better survive this. I'm almost done with this tutorial. There we go. Okay, now I'll survive. So there's the meteor and the nav card. What's the next piece on my list of notes? A table. Okay, we'll do that once I finish this round. So you now have the meteor, the nav card. You need to go attach the meteor. You will need to go attach the meteor to the navigation table, but the nav card you will just keep in your inventory. And let me actually show you where it is with my mouse. So like somewhere right here. I believe. Actually, you can't see my mouse in this game. At least you can't in multiplayer. I assume you can't in zombies. So it's on the right side above the turbine that you see with the number 1. Right above that is the nav card, so that means I already have the nav card. And you don't actually need to attach that to the navigation table. So now let's go on to the next part, now that you know where those two are. Okay, so the next piece that you will need for your navigation table is the table itself, and that can be in one of two locations, or one of three, depending on how you think of it again. The first place it can be is right here, where I found the jet engine. The second place it can be is, let's just cross this, it's over here. It can be either right here, or in the corner, right over there. So I guess that's three places, really. So those three places are in the tunnel. The fourth place is actually not anywhere even close to the tunnel. It would be in the power room. So we'll go over there next, and I'll show you that. So the other possible location for the table is in the power room, under the main platform, so down there. Let's actually go down there, and I will show you. Zombie won't jump down after me. So it can spawn right here, or up here, or right there, just pretty much anywhere under this main platform. That's the last location for the table, but most likely it'll be in the tunnel just because it has more spawn spots in the tunnel. So let's go on to the next part, and you will have to attach the table to the navigation table. So the next part you'll need for the navigation table is the card reader, or the transformer box, or whatever you want to call it, not really sure what it is. But it's one of the two locations it can be found is in the town here, Area 5, and it would be found right over here behind this chain link fence, or chain fence, or whatever you want to call it. And it'll be found right here, leaning on the dumpster, or right here, or somewhere here near the dumpster. And then let's go check out the second location of where it can be found over at the farm, Area 3. The second place you can find the... what was it? I just had it in my head. Card reader, transformer box, that thing, is on the left of the fridge over at the farm in the house. You'd find it right here. So that's the second location, and you will have to attach it to the navigation table. And now let's go on to the next piece, which is the radio. So the next part you'll need for the navigation table is the radio, and it's actually the last piece you will need. And that can be found in one of two locations. One is Area 2 of the diner, in the garage, at the top of the... of this thing. So like up here, you may have to jump to get it. And it can also be found at the top of that one. And... yeah. Now let's go on to the next place that you can find it, which is in Nocturne and Toten again. Okay, so now we're going to be looking for the radio in Nocturne and Toten. That's the second place it can spawn. We're not actually looking for the radio, we already have it, but we're going to be... I'm going to be showing you where it can spawn there. So we're at the farm, and I'm once again going to show you how to find Nocturne and Toten, just for those of you who skipped ahead to how to build the navigation table rather than watching all the previous ones, which I honestly don't blame you for doing if you did that. So running from the farm to the power area, because that's the cornfields are in between the farm and the power area, areas 3 and 4. And we're going to be looking on the right, I believe. Nocturne and Toten, it's on the opposite side of the power tower, so if we find either one, it has to be on the other side. Or if I find the appropriate car wreck, I can just find that. Okay, yeah, it is on the right. Here's the appropriate car wreck, the three cars. So let's go right, and we will find Nocturne and Toten. Yes, I know I can shoot these guys, I choose not to. So as you saw, I turned right over there, and then we're going to turn left in here. What just took me down? Did that trolley thing take me down? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, alrighty then. I can't die. I can't die again. I'm almost done. What's even left? Yeah, a couple things. So anyways, where the radio can spawn in Nocturne and Toten is possibly right here. And possibly over here, which is actually where I found it. Right here. So those are the two possible spots in Nocturne and Toten where the radio can spawn, and as well as the possible spots in the diner area, in the garage. And that is it for the navigation table. I've already shown it to you fully built, because it apparently was built from last game. Apparently you don't have to build it every game. At least in solo you don't. So next we'll be showing you how to build the Pack-a-Punch. And I might... if I want to show you... I don't know, I'll decide how to... if I want to show you how to... open Pack-a-Punch. I probably will, because it's actually a pretty necessary step, and if you can open Pack-a-Punch, you can probably build Pack-a-Punch. So, I'll show you how to open Pack-a-Punch, and then I will show you how to build Pack-a-Punch. Okay, so somewhat the last thing we're going to be building, it's not exactly the last thing, we still have bus upgrades to go, but the last thing we're actually going to be building on a workbench is the Pack-a-Punch thing, and to get to Pack-a-Punch, you have to place a turbine down here at the power area. You know how when you drop down, there's this power symbol right there? That's where you need to place a turbine. So I'm actually going to place it there, and we will have the power area open, And then off camera, I will run to where you actually go to do Pack-a-Punch. Okay, good. Zombie is following me. I don't want it hitting the turbine. So now we gotta run over to the town and go to the bank. So I will see you over there. I'm just gonna run it. So yeah, I'll see you there. Okay, so here we are at the bank in the town, and Pack-a-Punch is located right in here. You have to blow this door open with a grenade, blow this door open with a grenade, and then Pack-a-Punch is right down here. This is now open because we placed the turbine. So we need three parts for this. We need a table, a sign, and a battery. So I've actually already found all three parts just by looking here as I was talking. So here's the table. It's located right here. I don't have exact locations for each part, but they are really, really obvious, as you are about to see. Like, that table was pretty obvious. And let's go attach the table. Here's the workbench where we build the Pack-a-Punch machine. And it actually builds right here. So not exactly where the workbench is, but close enough. The next thing we need is the sign. So here's the Pack-a-Punch sign. And let's go attach it to the workbench. And then the next thing we need is the battery. So let's go grab that. I already saw it right here. There we go. A battery. And let's attach it. Not while the zombie is that close, though. Let's bring the zombie out here, and then we'll go attach it, and then Pack-a-Punch will actually be finished. So, attach the battery, and we are done. There we go. Pack-a-Punch is now operational, and we can upgrade our guns however much we want. And I'm actually going to do that just for the fun of it. So, let's upgrade this. I haven't used it much this game, but I'm going to upgrade it anyways. Because I don't want to upgrade this pistol, since I need ammo from this pistol. And I don't want to pay 4,500 for ammo every time. So, same sight, but I don't know what else is new about the gun. Basically, Pack-a-Punch is used for upgrading guns, as you saw. And we are done with Pack-a-Punch now. So next, I'm going to show you all the bus parts. And that's going to be a little complicated to explain, but I can do it relatively easily. So let's go on to bus parts. So now we're on the bus parts, which is the last part of this video or videos. I'm not sure how I'm going to do this yet in terms of editing. But bus parts. There are three parts in total. They are the plow, the hatch, and the ladder. And I have to explain all of this because they spawn randomly around the map, and there's no real other organized way I can do this. So one place they can spawn is here in the bus stop, and I don't want the bus to run over the zombie. I'll let the bus leave. So one place is the bus stop right in those doors, which can be accessed from the outside here, or they can be accessed from the inside next to the workbench. Once this bus leaves, we will go and look at those doors. Let's go now. And I don't have a turbine anymore. Can I grab another one? I already have one, so the one I left at Pack-a-Punch or at the power room is actually still alive. I'm gonna have to wait till I can get another one because I need a turbine to open these doors. And there may or may not be something in there. So, yeah. I'm gonna wait for the turbine at power to die, and then we will be right back. Okay, so the turbine at power is now dead, and I can now pick one up from here. So let's do that, and we will open these doors. Let me drag the zombie away from here so he doesn't attack my turbine. Come over here. There we go. And now let's go open the door by placing this. And once the doors are open, I'm actually going to pick up my turbine again so the zombie doesn't hit it. And it turns out that in this case, there is nothing here. If there was anything here, it'd be in the back right here. But there are no bus parts in this room this time around. But it is one possible spawn location for them. The next possible spot is at area number 2, the diner, so let's go over there. So here we are at the diner. It's the second possible spawn location for a bus part, and it's actually in this shed right here. I'm going to pick up the turbine as soon as the doors open. And in this case, the ladder is here, so that's one of the three. And we will attach it to the bus as soon as the bus gets here, because I don't want to move on to the next spot, because if you want to grab the next part, you have to leave this part, because you can only carry one part at a time. So if you grab a bus part, make sure you attach it to the bus before you go on and try to find more parts. Especially because they're in locked sheds that require a turbine to open. You don't want to be stuck needing a turbine to get another bus part, because that sucks. Trust me. So I'm going to wait for the bus and attach this, and then we will move on to the next possible spawn location for a bus part. Yay, the bus just arrived. Let's go attach the ladder. It goes on the left side of the bus, on the back of it, right here. So there we go. Now we have a ladder. We can climb on top of the bus from the outside, from the left side to be specific, and at the power place, the power area, area number 4. You know how you can't get back in the bus if you go into the power area? Now you can, because there's a ladder on that side. So now we're going to go to the next spot, which is actually at the farm. So area number 3. We're at the diner right now, which is area number 2. And I will see you in the farm, and I will show you the next possible spawn location for the bus parts. There we go. Farm, 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 farm. That's the next spot for the possible bus part location, and it's in the shed right here. Now, zombie, don't you dare go attack my turbine. Okay, good. And awesome, in this one we have a plow, and also something that's always in here is the claymores, which I'm not gonna buy this time because I don't need them, but those are there, always, no matter what, they don't randomly spawn. But in this case, we got the plow, and the bus is actually leaving. No, I want to go attach this before you leave. Don't leave yet. Let me attach this. Yes. Haha. It's attached. Is it not leaving? Did I just hear a horn for no reason because I've been playing this game for so long? Okay, then. Well, now the plow is attached, it goes at the front of the bus, as you saw. And now we will go on to the next possible spot for a bus part to spawn. Did I get my turbine back? Yes, I did. Okay, so the next spot is the town. So let's go there next. While we're on our way here, leaving the farm, I actually realized I didn't tell you what the plow does. It's kind of important. But what the plow does is, as it sits on the front of the bus, any zombie that's in front of the bus, instead of glitching through the bus, it'll kill any zombie in front, so they won't even come through those two windows because they die before they get there. So you can also use the bus as kind of a trap that way to make rounds go slightly faster. So now we're going to go on to the town and look at the last possible, well maybe not last, but the next possible bus part spawn location. So here we are at the town, and it's actually the last possible spot where the bus parts can spawn, and the locked door that requires a turbine is right over here, across from that fence and the dumpster. My turbine is dying! So, the last part I needed was the hatch, because I already have the ladder and the plow. Oh gosh, I didn't want to... No, it closed! Aw. Okay, turbine again. So the last part is the hatch, as you saw. That's what is in here. Let me pick it up. I don't actually need this turbine anymore, but I'm gonna keep it just in case. So the hatch is kind of interesting. There's two things you can do with it. One is put it on the bus, because it is a bus part, and it goes up here. You have to jump and then hold F and just keep holding F. But the other place it can go is in the diner, and I will show that. I won't attach it there, but I will show it. So I'm not going to attach it here yet, just to show you that it actually can go in the diner as well. Okay, so here we are at the diner. Let's get off the bus, and just as proof that you can put the hatch in the diner, go up here, and it says hold F to add part, so obviously it's a valid part. And what it does is it opens this, lets you get up, and then you can buy some brass knuckles or something. Some knuckles. But I don't think they're worth it, because the Bowie knife is just slightly worse, and you don't have to give up the hatch from the bus. I do prefer to have it on the bus, simply because sometimes you need to be able to get on top of the bus. So I'm going to add it to the top of the bus, and that will allow us to get on top of the bus from the inside. You have to double tap space, pretty much, to get up there. kind of a trick. Zombies here. But anyways, that's what the hatch is for, to get up there on top of the bus. And that actually finishes off this video, or these videos. That was the last thing to build. So hope you guys enjoyed, hope you found it informative more than anything. Even more than enjoyed, because I know I'm more of a teacher than an entertainer. And I will see you all in the next video.